putting on this this season, appropriately called No Song Unsung. And I'm Brent Beeson, the director of music therapy. Just want to welcome you tonight and cover a few announcements quickly. If you haven't had a chance to silence your phone, please take an opportunity to do that now. In the program, please note that there's extensive program notes, so if you want to follow along with the information for each piece and translations where that's needed, those are there to help you. Also in the program, right before the list of students in the choirs, is a couple of donation links. If you're not carrying cash but you'd still like to support the program, then there's a PayPal and a Venmo QR code there for you. And better now than later. And of course, we'll take cash as well if you have that and want to support the students. And if you're wondering where that money goes, then just flip to the next page, because that's where all the students' names are listed. Okay. Also on the back of the program, there's a QR code if you want to join the mailing list, if you're not on that already, for the choir, so that you can get updates on the choir's information. And now, if you'll help me welcome Dr. Jay Daugherty and the Marietta College Choirs.
Thank you all for being here tonight, and thank you, Brent, for the introduction. As he mentioned, we have some great program notes, with extensive program notes for each of our major ensembles. So if you want to follow along exactly what these songs are about and why we put them in the order we put them, you can follow along. Every kind of paragraph tells you about the next song. So I will refrain from speaking between songs for the most part and just take you through the journey of what the treble choir has to offer today. And the next one here is O Radiant Dawn.
Oh,
next set of songs is a set of, originally a set of Roger Quilter solo pieces that were, you know, they're old enough now from the early 20th century that they're in the public domain. So I was able to take these solo pieces and arrange them for a three-part choir. And so these next three songs are my arrangements. These will be this is the world premiere of these, so that's kind of fun for them, fun for me, fun for you, hopefully. So because it is a set of three short songs together, we will do these all three in a row without applause between until the end of the third song. And so here is Roger Quilter's Opus 3, set for treble choir.
Thank you.
choir. We have a really fun one called The Warrior. They're going to get set up. You'll see we'll have a little bit of a percussion, and you may even hear a voice from on high somewhere in the song. Watch out for that. Big fun song here. I actually chose the song just because it was a great one. I heard it at an ACDA convention, and I thought, oh, my treble choir's got to do that. Only to find out that one of our members of the treble choir had the composer of the song as our high school teacher. That's Liv here, right? Yeah. So that was a big surprise to me. That was, what a small world in the choral world, I guess. But that was kind of fun. So anyway, here is The Warrior. You good? You good? All right. This will be our final song for the treble choir. Seniors in our final concert and kind of tell you what they're going to be up to. So first here is Indy Flores. Yes, this is Indy, and she is a double major in political science and international leadership. She says she will be, after graduation here next week, she says, I will be solo backpacking through Central America, volunteering in local hostels as a bartender and yoga instructor in exchange for food and housing. She says, I fly to Belize first, then a bus to Guatemala with a program called World Packers. That sounds exciting. She spent several semesters in the treble choir over her 4 years here, and she says her favorite thing about being in the choir is just creating beautiful music with such a talented group of singers. So congratulations in your pending graduation and wherever you're headed after this. Congrats. We also have Kaylee Bowen up here, right in the center in the back. Kaylee is a vocal performance major. She's a marketing minor and also getting her certificate in vocal pedagogy. After graduation next week, she will be attending graduate school for her master's in vocal performance at Cleveland State University. I don't want to say it wrong. She'll be going to Cleveland State University, so that's exciting. We're very excited for her. Yes, thank you. Kaylee has been a part of while here at Marietta College are the concert choir. A lot of you have seen her over the years in concert choir. Treble choir, flood stage, jazz ensemble, wind ensemble, symphonic band, pet band, and the new music ensemble. She's a jack of all trades, so she does it all. And she says her favorite thing about the choirs, she really enjoyed making music with the talented and lovely people in the choirs. These experiences have made me a more versatile musician and singer. Congrats, Kaylee, on your pending graduation. So, as they transition, I get to introduce our next group, which is the first time we ever have had this group. We have a quartet that is going to sing for you, as you see in your program. This is... If anybody knows me at all, you know that I'm into barbershop harmony, so this is kind of an exciting guilty pleasure of mine that they get to sing here at this concert. I kind of put out some feelers at the end of last semester and said, hey, is anybody interested in maybe putting together a quartet? Had a bunch of people interested. We did some auditions, put together this group, and they are called, as you saw in your program, the Herman Hermits, and that is because... they spend a lot of time in the Herman Building, which is our music building. So it's called the Herman Fine Arts Center. So that they're the Hermits of the Herman Music Building. So the Herman Hermits, and they are going to present two songs for you in the barbershop style. Please enjoy.
Do
they come down the flood stage, as you all know, the flood stage, they had their big concert of the year about a week ago. So they're just going to give you one song tonight that they sang on that show, and then we'll carry on from there. So here is Flood Stage.
Ta-da-da.
as they're getting situated, this will be concert choir as our next ensemble and our final ensemble. As you see, hopefully in your programs, or you can check it out now, but we are basically going to take you on a history of choral music, starting from the early Renaissance and moving into contemporary modern music. So we have basically one piece from every major compositional period. And so if you read through the program note as we go on through these next several pieces, you'll be able to kind of learn how choral music changed and evolved throughout the centuries. So we will be starting with the Renaissance piece by Palestrina, very famous Renaissance composer. And then from there, we will move into the Baroque and then into the classical and so on. So enjoy the program note, enjoy our presentation of the history of choral music through singing.
Thank you.
you'll see in our program. It's called Take the Moon. This is an original composition that I wrote specifically for this concert, as we say farewell not only to you all for coming and being a part of this experience with us, but also to our seniors who will be going on to bigger and better things after graduation. So we say farewell to them, but it's just for now and not forever, and those are the words of the song. So this will be the world premiere of this this piece, Take the Moon. Thank you so much for coming. Before we get to that, I do want to acknowledge our senior that we have up here. So this is Elizabeth Rebay. Here she is. She's the one that gave a great solo in the middle of that song. How do you like that? Based on that solo, I'm sure you can guess what her major was, but she was a vocal performance major with a psychology minor. After graduation next week, she says, I plan on going back home to Detroit, Michigan and getting a job to help my mom out with bills while keeping up to date with vocal competitions and auditions in the area. We wish you well in that. She says she's been in the concert choir, the treble choir, flood stage, and she also had a cameo in the jazz ensemble recently. That was pretty awesome if you got to see that. And she says her favorite thing about being a part of the choirs is the music making. She says she loves SATB pieces specifically, and anytime we sing, I feel engulfed in the sound, and I can feel the colors and the harmonies swirling around me. So, Elizabeth, congratulations on your graduation. The First Congregational Church. We just love singing in this space. It's a beautiful space, and it's very nice and resonant, so thank you so much to those of you involved with that and letting us be here. We thank our administration at Merida College, very supportive of the arts and what we do. We love that. Want to give a special appreciation to our office administrator, Myra, who I think is here somewhere. Is Myra here somewhere? I'm going to call her out. I thought she was coming tonight. Come on, Myra. She's gone. Well, Myra's awesome, so we love having Myra around, so thank you, Myra. And especially, we couldn't do this without Marilyn, so thank you so much, Marilyn. I gotta tell you, there's not a lot of choral directors in the world that get to work with such a fantastic collaborative pianist, and her talent is just amazing. We just love being able to work with her, so thank you, Marilyn. And of course, I'd be remiss not to say thank you to the students, all these singers up here and up here. I mean, what a joy this year has been, and this semester in particular, just as you can hear, just the phenomenal musicians that they are and how they have stepped up to just put on some great music for you. They love what they do, obviously, and I love what I do, getting to work with them every day. So thank you for making my year. Thank you all for coming and being here tonight. And to finish off our concert, here is Take the Moon.